Hey guys, remember that time last time when I said, hey guys, I'll see you next time? That's right now! So here we are, getting ready to do hacking stuff. Actually, not so much hacking stuff tonight. Probably going to do something a little bit graphical. I thought that would be some fun. Work with some GIMP. I had a lot of fun doing a bunch of stuff for Children of Vector, and I kind of ran out of things to do for my own hack, so I decided I would do something else. And so we recently made a FF6 Hacking Twitch channel, and I'm going to design a banner for it. But before we do that, I'm going to do a quick once over of the learning magic portion of the new magic update, because I got that working, and it's kind of neat. And then the next thing I'm working on here is spell order and trimming, because I thought that learning magic was going to be the hard part, but now I'm running into another roadblock, like, literally the very next thing I go into, so. Of course, I knew something was going to happen. Here it is. But anyway, so let's take a look at some of that stuff. How's everyone doing tonight? Hopefully well. I had a kind of a... My brain's been mush recently after the last couple weeks of doing really heavy coding with Trance and the magic update and stuff like that. My brain has not been in tip-top shape. Actually had an incident this last week. I was driving to work on a major interstate, and I'm driving in some form of traffic, and I pass on the side of the road a discarded snow shovel. It's a nice big snow shovel. The first thing that goes through my head was, oh my gosh, free snow shovel. Keep in mind it is July, the middle of the summer, at 6 o'clock in the morning, and I'm considering pulling over to put a snow shovel in my car. So that's where my brain's been all week. So hopefully you guys are doing a little bit better than that. Oh man. So anyway, we're going to take a quick... Actually, I can just load that up here. I don't even need to. Come on. Yeah. So, some cool stuff. Where is my Notepad++? Man, everything's taking a long time to move today. I got my new computer ordered. So hopefully that'll be running in the next few weeks. I've got to put it together and stuff. But... I'm gonna do it. All right, magic. So you see I've got all these tables in here. And I actually have all my code in here. So for the learning spells, this is literally basically exactly what we went through. I had to change a couple minor things, but it doesn't differ from the logic. It was just a quirk of how I had to do it. I don't remember exactly what it was actually, but I remember a couple things that I had to adjust slightly in my debugging process. It may have been in the learn spell bit, actually, which we didn't go over on camera. I ended up doing that myself. But that was fun. But everything worked exactly the way it ought to. It just took a small amount of debugging. I got through it in less than a day. But yeah, so the thing I'm going to point out, though, is we talked about all these tables here. And we've got the one that's like the actual spell that it's going to say that it's learning. And so we're going to load this up. And I actually have a save state, I think, in slot one here. Of course, you can't find the slot. Oh, hold on. Let me run the game first and then see if I can do a... There we go. I don't know if this is the one that I want. Well, do you have... Yes, you do have... things. Okay. Alright. So all this stuff is still going to look like vanilla. It's, so it says she already knows fire, which she would. And then weirdly enough, it says she has 3% on poison, because she has, I believe, 3 AP currently on Siren, which is Esper number, I think, 5. Or maybe it's 3. I don't know what it is. 0, 1, 2. Poison is spell ID 3. All right, and so I'm actually going to set up a breakpoint here because I'm going to need to inject a bunch of AP magic points, not AP. We were calling it AP, so we'll just stick with that. And I'm going to have it do that. We'll have that do that. No, actually, I don't know if it even runs this code. Because it's not going to think it has AP. We'll do it when we hit... actually, we'll do it when we hit the learn Espers code. So C26012. So breakpoints, C26012. So we're not going to get the AP message. Oh, I was at a level up because I also implemented the level up learning magic. That's why I was out here. Now I remember. And so you'll be able to see actually. The next spell Terra's supposed to learn is sleep. And that should actually work properly. I'm going to speed up here to get through it. Hey, Lock Kirby. Good to see you. I'm just putting on display some of the learning magic stuff. So Terra gained a level. Terra learned and dot. So I got learning magic working with level up, and then so the thing I want to show off actually with that, so let's go back to here. Actually, no, we can't go back to there. Actually, I need to open up the ROM, and I'm going to change something in that little table. I'm gonna go up here, and I don't remember what's the spell ID for antidote. Hey, Genotech. All right, cool. We got people now. We got people. I'm just showing off that this is working, and then I'm going to jump into the graphical stuff that I talked about, unless anyone has anything else they want me to do. Antidote is index 50, which in hex is some other number. How you guys doing today? What have you guys been up to? 50, 32. All right, so 32. So it'd be what? 3, 1, 2. Right there, 22. Wait a second. No, I'm sorry. I'm sorry. It will actually be 32, not 32. 32, right there. So that one in here, and I need to go where that is, which is somewhere around C26500. Somewhere around here, right here. All right, so this spell here, I'm going to change to a different ID. In fact, I'm going to change it to F0. I'm going to change this to F0. So what I'm doing is when it goes and it's checking for the spell, spell number 32, it's going to pull the information for another spell. All right. So I did that. I saved it. And let's load this back up. And fast forward. All right. Do do do. 38 AP. Terra gained a level, and she learned Riot Blade. So, basically, I've got a table in here that's going to be used for what actual spell is going to be used. So I'm going to basically call this same place when it's pulling the names for the spells and when it's pulling the information for when the spell is being used as an attack. Just gonna let you guys know, the thunderstorm going on outside, just in case for whatever reason I get cut off, that might be why. I may have been struck by lightning. But anyway, so Terra can learn Riot Blade apparently. Now this is still only setting a bit, so the game actually doesn't know how to work with it, because I haven't written that part yet. But essentially, you can turn your magic list into any set of spells that you want it to be, because I created a table. Which is going to work well, because I'm adding 10 additional slots for spells. And it doesn't make a whole lot of sense to make them the first 10 Espers, because why? Which someone could do that, but I decided to make it so that... Yeah, we'll see. I didn't take my usual bath in toxic chemicals, So it may not do get the full effect. I may not get the full effect that I would normally. Anyway, so the reason why this table is in place is to make it so that it's adaptive. So that your spells don't have to be, you don't have to move everything in order to do this. You can just set the spells that you want in there and do that. Although I will say at some point I would like to expand the actual ability list and basically double that. But for now, that's the way it works. So that's all working. And then the next thing that I'm working on here, and that's actually, I don't even have that in here yet. And I was doing some stuff. I don't need that open anymore. Don't need that open currently. Let's just do this. Yeah, so this right here is the next big roadblock. This all here is when what it's doing is it's finding all the magic spells that your party learns and is putting them in RAM with the spell ID. And then it takes the whole thing and it copies the list, and it does it with the lores too. And then it copies the whole list by what the spell order is supposed to be because of your configuration. So whether it's supposed to be, you know, black, white, gray, or white, black, gray, or what have you. So then it reorders it, and then it squishes it down so that it doesn't have a ton of blank spaces. It only has a few blank spaces, and there's a system for how it shows that stuff. And then it goes through the whole list again and loads spell number, like targeting byte, MP cost, and like something else for each individual character. Okay, and so that's where my big roadblock is right now. Because I'm adding extra spells, I don't have... Hey, Sir Knight Dude. Good to see you. Welcome to chat. So it basically loads a bunch of stuff for each character. Lock Kirby, you might have information on this. One of the things it saves is the targeting byte for each spell, and it saves it for each character. Is the targeting byte something that is ever actually affected by a relic or anything else? Because if not, I might try to condense that down into a single list that it always pulls from, and use that to create some extra space. Because what it's doing is it's creating all these lists in the RAM that exist throughout battle for each character so that the game can quickly call up what it needs for each spell for each character. Because the MP list changes, each character has their own magic list, so it basically stores all those things in a place so that it can readily pull it up in C1 as it needs to grab it. And so I need to figure out a way to condense that down so that it can fit 10 additional spells for each person. So yeah, so that's my big roadblock right now. I haven't put a whole lot of work into it. Like I said, I don't know how many people were in here, but my brain's been mush this week. There was a whole big story. There was a whole thing about a snow shovel. So go back and catch this later. Nah, I'm stuck buffering. Anyone else buffering? I'm buffering myself. Hopefully I didn't lose connection. That would be bad. Let me see what's going on here. Let me see. If you guys can still see and hear me, let me know. All right, well, I got a... Man, my stuff's running real slow right now, but I just got... All right, well, if it's working for everyone else, if I'm the only person that's affected by it... I guess if anyone, as much as I enjoy watching myself up here. Anyway, so I'll get back more into that stuff next week. My brain is mush right now. So I'm going to do some fun stuff. No, I'm going to quote you. I'm going to quote you. I'm sorry. Too bad. Yeah, I know, right? Well, I guess I'll just kill myself here on Twitch. Actually, let me just close that one entirely and see if it'll reload up. It wasn't loading anything else for me either, so I'm also streaming and recording right now, so maybe that's a thing. And there's a storm outside, so all those things together, we will see. But anyway, so we're going to do something a little bit more chill tonight. I'm going to hop back to here, and hop back to here, and hop into here. So I am working on a new banner for our new Twitch page. And if I go to twitch.tv/FF6Hacking, of course it's not going to load up, because nothing's loading up right now. Well, actually, you know what? I wouldn't be surprised if having that up. Everything's been quirky with my computer recently. No, I'm not going to do that. I'm just going to kill the picture of myself. Yeah, look, I'm not getting anywhere. It's like not even doing anything. Which is weird that all my streaming still works. I'm pinging Google just fine. I don't even have any kind of real noticeable latency. Is my DNS working? What's my DNS? I have a lot of interfaces. Why do I have like 8 tunnels? Let's kill that. Let's kill that. Ugh, I need to check on some of this stuff. What is my DNS? You know what? Not time to worry about it. Nah. GIMP's really cool. Like, the more that I get into it, the more impressed I am. Can I get anything up? Let's try XKCD. Nothing. Okay, here we go. I'm glad my upload's working, but man, my download's just not a thing tonight. All right, well, forget you. So long as GIMP works, I'm okay. So the only stuff I've grabbed so far, actually, I'm gonna need to get on some stuff because I didn't actually download a whole bunch, a couple of the pictures that I want to use. Well, it's kind of like my actual job, so I'm supposed to know some stuff. Alright, so the only thing that I've done so far, recently closed, and I don't want you up there, I want you down here where everyone can see you. Alright, so the only thing I've done so far is I've got 2 layers here, and one's got the Southern Continent World of Balance, Southern Continent World of Ruin, and some other stuff. Okay, and this is in the recommended, the full size here is the recommended size for the banners. For Twitch. Now it's buffering for you. Well, chat's still working, right? Man, if my connection goes down, I'm gonna be annoyed. I can't even run speed test while I'm streaming because it'll probably kill my stream, because speed test like takes everything. Alright, so this is my plan. What I'm going to do is I'm going to create kind of a gradient between these two, and I'm going to basically fade in and out of each one, and then in the back, I'm going to put some hex and give it some nice, like, shading, and in the middle, I'm going to put a picture of the floating continent, okay, and so then the idea is going from World of Balance to World of Ruin with floating continent in the middle, which is the transition point. And then in that transition point, we're going to have, like, you know, behind everything, we'll have, like, a fissure with hex behind it. And so that is representing what we do as hackers, right? We take something, we make it something else. Specifically, Final Fantasy VI. So I think it's all very nice and telling. And I also kind of like that this right here actually becomes the floating continent. So ta-da! So that's the plan. All right, and so you guys get to watch me do that from here, unless I get cut off. Well, as long as you can refresh, as long as you guys can refresh and keep going, that's the plan. As long as people are talking, I'm gonna keep going. All right. If you guys get like totally silent on me, then I might just throw my hands up. All right. So what I want to do is I want to get another background layer. And I'm gonna put some hex in there, which I actually used for, my own banner. I need to open up a new window, don't I? Wherever you may be. Documents. These two. All right. And what is the size here? Now, GIMP has a tendency to crash on me a lot, like a lot of other programs. That's another reason I can't wait to have another working computer, is that I will hopefully not have all these weird problems that I have with this one. All right, so I've got those in there. What am I doing? I need to chop it down to 480 on the height. And I actually only probably need one of these. Edit with GIMP. And what's going to be viewable? Actually, I kind of like that size, but do I like that size in relation to this? It's what? Are these both at 100%? All right, 100% there. Yes, these are both at 100%. All right, so that's, I hold my fingers up to it. We're looking at about that many, right? Okay, that's plenty of hex. I don't think I need it really any smaller than that. Maybe a little bit. Actually, yeah, let's scale the image and let's see how it looks at 50%. And that was probably half off camera for you guys. Actually, that's too small. It's too small. I don't think I want that much hex appearing behind everything. It's kind of a peripheral. Oops. It's lost everything there. I was shaking everything and then things just moved around. There we go. All right. My picture not changing? Oh, my picture's not changing because that got closed. There we go. Yeah, so that's going to look a little bit small on there. And I'm used to having a little bit more real estate to work with. All right, so what we're going to do, we're going to do that. And let's scale image. Let's do it to 80%. That's a good number. I like that. Okay. And I don't really need to cut a chunk out of it. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a new layer. And we're going to move you to the bottom. And let's paste in here. You can do it. No? Select all. Copy. I don't want any of that. Paste. Come on. Come on. Stop selecting things. There we go. All right. That should be all I need. And it can literally just sit right there in the middle. All right. Thanks for coming, Night, Sir Night Dude. We'll catch you next time. Yeah, that's what we're going to do. All right, so that's... It's only going to take up a little bit of space here in the middle. It's just going to kind of come up like that. Maybe I'll just do them diagonal for now because I was actually looking into how to do a gradient on a curve, but I didn't get it fully worked out. But this is what we're going to do. So this is how we're going to start creating gradients for this stuff. I'm going to lose a little bit of color on those if I'm thinking about this the right way. All right. So lots and lots and lots and lots of layers. We make all sorts of layers. I'm gonna call this World of Ruin. What are you doing? World of Ruin. Call you World of Balance. Okay, and this will be World of Ruin Gradient. And we're gonna go to our gradients tool. And let's see what options we have. Maybe I'll do like a radial one and then chop it. Because that would give me kind of a shaped angle. Angular. What's that going to look like? Let's get rid of this and see what this looks like when I make it. That's not a thing. Oh. What did that do? Is this me or is that not changing anything? Yeah. Alright, that's not doing what I want it to do. There is, so there's this other thing where we can do divide. This is what I was reading about today. The problem is, I don't really know. I could do foreground to transparent. No, wait, I need, actually, yeah, that should work fine. Foreground to transparent. And this foreground color, gotta pick a color that we're not really using a whole lot of, so I'm gonna do nice hot pink. And you guys can't see that. So hopefully that will not. Alright, so foreground to transparent. Not angular, we're going to use if I do bilinear and I make you, why are you doing things like that? What do you look like? No, I said I didn't want it to be that angular crap. Alright, come on. Just show me a regular. What is it that you think you're doing now? Oh, because I still have that divide on there. Hold on. Hold on. Let's do normal. That should... Oh, no. What did I do? Oh, you know why? You know why? Because I'm doing foreground to transparent, so it's keeping, like, half the picture in every time. All right. All right, I'm learning things as we go. But this is how I do things. Let's make a new layer. And we're going to delete that layer. Now, go back into here. I do want to try that bilinear, though. Wait, did that actually get erased? Oh, look at that. I can still use that. How did that even happen? All right, let's get rid of this. I'd like this to be up top. I'm going to grab it like this. That's not what bilinear looks like. All right, whatever, linear. I'll just do it in a couple layers. All right, so this is what we're doing. Got to figure out where I want this to go. Not quite like that. In fact, I would like it to be done by right about there. I can probably work with that. That's not too bad. Now, what we can do, actually, for now, I'm just going to leave it like that, and now move up to this guy. You, quite similarly, are going to go like this. That's not working for me. Let's make sure I'm on the right layer. That was not good enough. Not good enough. If I can see that, if I can see that hard line, then I'm doing something wrong. How sharp is that? That's like right about there. That's right about there. Means I probably drew it something like that. Come on. There you go, that's not bad. Alright, let's see how this turns out. Actually, that is a little bit harder than I want it to be. I'd like that to be a little bit softer. Come on. What's even happening? Oh, it's doing all those. Did this go away yet? There we go. Okay. There. All right, so let's make this a little... We're still going to start here, but I just want it to be a little bit longer. Ah. That actually wasn't so bad. All right, I think that's what I'm going to use. All right, this is all going to make sense in a second. All right, so this is what we're going to do in order to get rid of this. I need to copy my color code and merge that sucker down. So now you're linked. So now this is just one picture, and I can't make that go away. And I'm on this layer, colors, color to alpha. And this is why I need to have that color code. And watch. Boo! Goes away. Goes away. Now I'm actually getting a little bit of like random transparency now in the actual thing, which I will work out later. In fact, maybe I should put more hex back there. I don't know. I'll figure out how I want to solve that shortly. All right, and we're gonna do the same thing over here. We'll merge that down. And on that layer, now we are going to go color to alpha. It's the same color. And see what we're getting here? I'm getting a little more taken out than I would like. So I might have to think about how I want to do that so that that is not quite so what it is. But you see where I'm going with it. You see where I'm going with this. There's a way I can do this. I just have to figure it out. What I could hypothetically do is, so we're gonna see if this works. And if it doesn't work, I can always back up. Okay, so what I need to do is I need to grab another color in here and maybe do that same thing with that same gradient behind it and try to just basically re-add some color back in. See what I'm doing there? See how I did that? Ooh, actually, you know what I can do that with? I can do that with the color I would like to use for the background. Just gonna for like the hex background, it's gonna be like a nice, that's actually not gonna look as perfect as I want it to. Let's do it this way. It's interesting, I'm adding just a little bit of color each time. Let's go way back, and we're gonna, and I would like that to be just a little bit brighter. All right, and now I'll go back to the red because that was a little bit more like what I wanted, and I'll do a smaller one to try to correct the color in the world of ruin. How's that look? It doesn't look quite right, but you know what? Actually, let's go back one more. Let's get rid of all that. Let's go back to my pink because that's literally the color that I made disappear, and I'm just going to add it in more thickly. Yeah, see? Ah, too much. Too much. I think I only want one. There we go. That's not so bad. That's not so bad. We still kind of have a hard edge over here, but I can fix that. That might be a little more than I want to cut off, but yep. Yep, I'm working on the banner. Hopefully this is making sense what I'm doing. Let me make that longer. I don't like that. All right, let's go back to the blue. Make the blue nice and long. Except I don't want that. It needs to be in a new layer. Because it's got to be behind this partially transparent layer. All right, so let's make that a lot longer. And now let's go back over here. And now I can do this sort of long. All right, so that's mostly color corrected and still kind of transparent. Let's do a new layer underneath that and add some black. Yeah, I think I'm getting a little further off than I'd like to be. That's all right, let's see what we can do with the world of balance. Let's make some new layers for that. Oh, we'll add two layers to work with here. All right, so let's, same thing. Let's use our blue. Get a nice long one that gets into the hex area. It's a little bit more. Actually, I could do that blue gradient actually on the, hex layer. I probably don't need to split that up. All right, and then we're going to put back some of the color that we took out. And you see how that, like, fixes the color, like, really well? Because that was actually the color that we subtracted from the image to make it that transparent. I'm just going to do it a little bit longer. So that's why it looks so well color corrected. So that doesn't even look that bad. I would like it to be tighter and the line to be a bit harder, which actually I can do. Actually, I can do that. Hold on. All right, so this is what we're going to do. I'm going to go back. I'm going to go all the way back to here. And I'm going to go to the gradient. And there's a way I can set. Let's edit. No. I don't want it to be a new preset. I just want it to be, edit. Here we go. All right, so what I need to do is I can drag this one way or another or something. Shoot, click, yeah. Select, drag, move, extend selection. Come on, I should be able to do things with this. I should be able to lengthen or shorten. Yes, this is exactly the one I wanted to do, so why can't I do anything with it? Maybe I can't edit this one because it's preset. All right, well. You see, I've got one in here that I made for Children of Vector. That was for the Magitek armors. Whoa! But I'm not doing that right now. If I did it down here. That actually looks really cool. Actually, I could probably work with that. If I made the outside color, that works interestingly well. Because it's fixing both sides simultaneously. You know what I'm going to do? I'm going to go in here. And I'm going to try to... Let's see if there's just a regular one. Kind of like the Children of Vector one, but with foreground and background. It does not look like it. All right, so let's edit this. Yeah, see how there's this other stuff? And I can drag those to make them all different shapes and sizes. All right, so how do I change my colors here? It may be that I, look, see, and these ones I can move. Left color type. Endpoint color, haha. All right, so we're gonna do that. No, wait, I'm not done. What'd I just do? Editor. Yeah, stay here, editor. All right, I need to fix the other side, and then in the middle it's going to be like a blue highlight. And now I want this. Okay. left endpoints, right endpoints color is going to be blue. All right, now on this side, left endpoints color blue. Right endpoints color pink. Okay. And that should be a good spacing. I'm not too worried about that. Bring that in just slightly. No. Just stay put. Now, can I save you as a new one instead of saving you over? Oh well. No. Oh well. I don't feel like making a new one from scratch, so that's what we're gonna use. Alright. So now we're on this bottom layer here. And I'm just gonna go whoop. No. I don't want too much, because if I get too much, then I start to see more pink, and that's not what I want. Make it a little bit longer so that it does that. And now watch. Now this is the cool part. Now that we've got this, and hopefully this doesn't pull too much. I think I made this thin enough that this will work. So now that we're on here, now we're going to use another alpha. And actually, I need to get the color code for this. Color to alpha. And U. Alright. I need colors that are polar opposites. I shouldn't have been using a random color. I should have been using very distinct colors. Because when you use colors that are polar opposites, it's a lot easier to do stuff like that. So I'm gonna do something else with that, I think, because I want to keep that. And so what I want to do then is think really hard. I want to remove just a little bit. Maybe I could just cut into it instead of maybe we could just cut into it instead of creating a fade, kind of like a cracked surface. Like hypothetically, if I were just to draw like something like that, like a cracked surface. Now, of course, that'll look kind of dumb like this, but if I cut it out, ta-da, there's the hex behind it. And some other stuff in front of it. I would have to merge those layers down before I did that if I wanted that. But something along those lines. Something along those lines. And then on top of it, and I need to try to get another browser up. See if I can do this. Continent. I still don't have any internet. My internet's still doing absolutely nothing. That's kind of a roadblock, because I wanted to put a big floating continent there, like the one from like Balance and Ruin, if you guys have seen that, from the, OC Remix. Cut out of a Moogle. I am so annoyed that I have nothing right now. It's like my DNS is dead. Let me see, does it work better if I use Google's... No, I'm getting nothing. I just have nothing. This is such a huge pain. It might work if I restart Firefox, but I can't do that without killing my chat. Let me try... Heaven forbid, Internet Explorer. Just real quick. Please forgive me. No, I still got crap. Okay. Well, I'm kind of stuck with whatever I have locally saved on my computer. And I'm too afraid to touch anything because I don't want to break anything. So I could put this in there. Maybe just like a big picture of the Magisite. Honestly, I have so much crap. I should have something. Yeah, I know, right? At least that's working. My upload's right on. It's like someone snipped my download lines. But you know what? I am downloading the chat, which is extremely tiny, but still. All right, what do I have floating around in here? Some old stuff. What in the world? I don't know what that is. I don't think I've got anything in here. What's that? Oh, this is where all my stuff came from for building the Children of Vector splash page. All right, well, for now, instead of getting that part, let's add some text. Where's... No, go away. I don't want to do that. GIMP. Oh, we can close that. I don't really need that. Let's add some text. Let's add some text with black lettering. With black lettering. 100% black. For now. Actually, you know what? White might actually work better for what we've got right now. Just to get it viewable, and then what I'm going to do is I'm going to add some stuff around it. Let's do black, and then I'll outline it in white. I think that's how Final Fantasy works, right? Black outlined in white. Alright, and what I'm going to use, if I double-click on here, I can bring this up. And I've got a couple cool ones. This Ferrum one is the one I use for Final Fantasy, but Final Fantasy also works. This one has a bunch of weird symbols, and the spacebar doesn't work. Spacebar adds a big square, and I don't want that. So Ferrum is designed to look a lot like it. Are you crashing on me? Please don't crash on me. I haven't saved this in a while. There. All right, so I've got Ferrum, and it's probably going to have to be pretty big. Why are you in, like, no color whatsoever? Let's put you on top. There we go. Yeah, you can't see anything, obviously. All right, so we're going to make you larger. So FF6 hacking. The one thing I don't like about this one is it doesn't have lowercase letters. They're all... I could do it like that. Or I could do something that's not in Final Fantasy type. Yeah, that's probably a good idea. Problem is, I undo a lot of stuff, as you just saw. And I don't want anything to accidentally get stuck. I would rather redo, like, 18 steps than save constantly and accidentally, like, get to the point where I can't, like, have it crash on me. Because GIMP crashes a lot. And so if I save on something I'm not sure about and then it crashes, I'm screwed. I kind of like how we use this. I don't know what to use. Maybe I can just call it Final Fantasy VI hacking. And that way... Come on. What are you doing here? Let's go back in here. There we go. Confirm text editing. Yes, that is what I'm trying to do. Yes, edit. So let's do Final Fantasy VI, and let's shrink that guy down. And then I'll put hacking on another line. You really still can't get up there? 126. Nah, there's something wrong with that. There we go. Final Fantasy VI. And actually, that's all we're going to do on that one. And I'll check to make sure that that's... Actually, let's do that now. So this is how I make sure it's centered, because I'm super anal about everything. If you haven't figured that out already, is I zoom into the pixel, and I find out where I'm at. So you can see down here on the bottom, right here, it's going to show my coordinates. So I'm at 33 here, which means if this is 900 wide, I should be getting to about 867. I hate trying to fit everything on one tiny little portion of my screen. All right, so this right here, about 849. So what I actually need to do is slide this sucker over about 19 squares, because that would just be on the other side. So 18, I need to scoot it over about 9 squares, about 9 pixels. All right, so that 33 is going to move to 42. 7, 8, 9-ish. What are we at, 42? Okay, score. All right. All right, so that should be about center. Final Fantasy VI. All right, that's one, and then I need to do another one that's going to say hacking. Oh, actually, you know what? There is one. There is one, but I still check the pixels. I could do, because you can justify the text, and so as long as the box is the correct size, it will center it perfectly in your box. I totally forgot about that, but I generally tend to literally go and view the pixels to make sure I'm doing that right. All right. So I'm going to do something else here real quick before I do the next portion of the text. And that is, I don't need to really have anything selected for this. But I'm going to do select by color, and I've got to be on the correct layer. And I am. In fact, I'm going to can I put two new layers, or is this going to stay permanently like it? Okay, actually, I think this can stay the way it is. All right, and so what I do is click on it like this, and it selects all of the text, but it's around all the text. So this is selection by layer, and this is really neat. Take this, and we're going to go to edit down here. We're going to go stroke selection. And how much do we want to stroke it by? This is 900. So we're going to want, let's see what 6 pixels look like. Hopefully that's not too crazy. Oh, shoot. I forgot to switch the color. Excuse me. All right. Now we're on white. Now we're going to stroke the selection. Whoa, it's too much. Undo. Try that again. Stroke selection. Let's go down to 3. Actually, yeah. That looks pretty good. I don't want it too thin. I think on my Children of Vector stuff, I think I made my borders just a little too slim. Oh yeah, lag. Lag's picking up. It could be the storm outside. It could be my computer. I'm not entirely sure what it is. Actually, you know what? I am going to go back. I'm going to do that one more time with 2. Let's do 2 pixel stroke. Oh, yeah, that's nice and clean. That's pretty. All right, cool. Final Fantasy VI. And we'll make another one down here that's just going to say hacking. And I can put that in another font. Anyone have any fonts I really like? Or any that, I don't know, stick out to you? Alaska. Alright. Nah. It's not bad, it's kind of eh. Comic Sans. I used to use Comic Sans all the stinking time. Anytime I made something when I was a kid, it was always in red and Comic Sans. Like everything I made. Wingdings, really? Really, Gein Attack? Oh, man. Wingdings. I don't even know why I asked you people. Ariel. And we're going to drop that down to about, I don't know, let's do 110. Meh. Just use Times New Roman. Honestly, what does this use? That's not what I want. Oh, well, I guess I can open anything I want in a hex editor. This is probably just like Times New Roman. Yeah, I just opened up my text file. Look. Whole thing. Yeah, in a hex editor. Kind of neat being able to look at literally anything in your computer in machine code. But I think having it look like, kind of looking like a hex editor would be kind of cool looking. I just don't know what that is. It's probably like Times New Roman. It's got to be something really standard. Or like something that looks like a console, which I'm not sure what that would look, what that would be. Does anyone know off the top of their head what Courier look like? I would need to bold it if I was doing that. And if my internet was working, I could look up what font command line uses. What font does CMD use? But it's not going to do anything because it's just going to sit there forever. Isn't it so nice? All right, we're going down here. Steam Wreck, that's the one I use for Children of Vector. That's the one I downloaded. Nice. And I have a Jedi one that I used when I made the little tiny banner for Status Wars. I downloaded a Jedi-looking one. Oh, Terminal. I bet Terminal has something to do with being used on a terminal. Well, not that. It's really weird, and I mean that looks too boring. Times New Roman. That's gonna have, probably end up being what it has to be. Except I want it bold. Ah, what'd I just do? Yeah, see, I can change my alignment here. I just am silly. FF6 hacking. But yeah, I want that bolded. Where do I do that? Alright, I can work with that. Alright, let's go back to here. Let me move some of this stuff out of the off screen. Because I need to be able to see what I'm doing here. All right, I've got it center justified, so let me just see if I can, I'll do it the easy way and make sure that my box is in the right spot. And as long as my box is in the right spot, it should make the right spot for that. All right, and then we're going to do the same thing. Shoot, you made your own text, right? Okay, good. Select by color and that. Flip, edit, stroke selection, 2 pixels. All right, and select none. Let's get off of, stop showing me things. There we go. So that's what we're kind of looking at right now. This looks a little too similar while at the same time looking different, which is kind of distracting to me. So I'd like to change this. I've got about half an hour left. I don't know. Anytime, this is going to sound really weird, but every time I see it, most of the time when Madseer writes it, it's always in all lowercase. And so for some reason, that's just like in my brain is the way it should be written down. In fact, on the Twitch channel, I think it's capital FF for FF6, even though, again, I was really tempted just to put lowercase. And then hacking, I think, is all lowercase. But yeah, this looks just a little bit too distracting. I could also make a bar under here like it does for Final Fantasy, and that might actually take away some of that. Let me go to this line, and I'm going to make my own little selection thing. This is actually how you make lines in GIMP. Actually, I'm gonna have to do this to a new layer, aren't I? So that I don't stroke the same thing again. So new layer. And we're just gonna make a little bar. And it's literally just going to be 2 pixels. And I gotta make sure I drag it in. Yeah. Right. Lined up with that. And it's just gonna be a small little guy. Make sure I'm staying right where I wanna stay. Alright. And nope, come on. Back up. Zoom in where I want you to zoom. No, not that, dummy. There we go. Yes, okay. Alright, and so this is what we do. We do that little thing, and that actually looks like that's going to be super, super tiny. So I'm going to make that just a little bit bigger. How many pixels is that? Should tell me down at the bottom, actually. No! Show me the selection. Do not lose that selection, please. Six pixels enough? All right, that'll be fine. 6 pixels is good. All right, and then we're going to bucket fill that right there. And now that's already my selection, so I just got to flip it. Edit, stroke selection, 2 pixels just like everything else, and ta-da. In fact, how about... Can I do it with some feathering? I should be able to feather the selection, I believe. If I go to selection and I do feather, and we're just gonna do one. And what that does is nothing. Hold on. Let's do, wait, shoot. I think that's actually, oh wait, pixels. Never mind. I was about to say, I think it's a percent, but it's not. All right, so let's do 2. And that's not doing anything for me. It's probably because there's no shape to it. That's probably what it is. All right, never mind. I'm going to stroke the selection. Now, if I do 2, it's always really nice. It's a really hard line. And so let me see what it looks like with 1. And that kind of gives it more of like a round effect. Let's do 3. And see how that gives it kind of like a little bit of extra texture there? Like it doesn't quite come out right. But that does look thicker there, which I'm not sure I'm a fan of. So let's just go back to select none. Yeah. All right. Hold on. One more thing. Edit. Stroke selection. Let's just try 1. So that makes it a much more faded line. I don't like that. I don't like that. All right, and I'm also gonna drag it down a little bit. So let me make sure I'm on my dragging tool here. And we're gonna cut it, and then we're gonna paste it, and we're gonna drag it down. And I need to make sure that I stay lined up, so come over here. And I'm just gonna drag that down. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 pixels. There we go. All right. It does have it capitalized on the site, you're right. Oh. Should anchor to the proper layer. Okay, there we go. Select by color. That other part doesn't exist. Why'd you select both parts of that? Oh, that's frustrating. Alright, so what I'm gonna do then, I'm going to anchor this to a new layer. And that one, I'm just going to delete. I don't need you anymore. Come on, layer 2, go away. Delete it. All right, let's go back up here. Select by color. That should now work. Okay, there we go. And edit, stroke, 2%. Bam. What's with this yellow line in there? Why is there one black line and then... I mean, why is it two different size lines? What is wrong with this thing? That looks weird. Actually, it's not that bad. Almost looks like it gives it a little bit of depth. And you see over here, too. It kind of gives it, like, a harder edge here, which bugs me a little bit. I don't know. A little ing. No, I know what you're talking about. They're like the floating guys. They're like, they look like ghosts / skeletons / biological monsters. I know what you're talking about. I would have really loved to get that hex showing up behind here, though. Oh, hold on. And I was actually looking at that exact thing. I'm going to do this lasso. And I'm going to do... I'm going to use the markers up here, so to be around, like, 550 here. And I'm going to go down. And what is the midpoint here? If it's 900, 450, so 550 is 100 away. So that means from 450, I'm going to 350 down on the bottom here. Oh, that's cutting it directly in half, though. That's not quite what I want. In fact, let's go to... let's go to 400. And then we'll go over about 300. And then go up to about 450. No, okay. So that's less than I want. Let's undo that. No, don't undo that. Shoot. Edit, redo. Redo. Just can't undo my selection until I'm done with that. There we go. Let's merge down. Because I need this all to come out of the same place. Actually, you know what? I don't necessarily need that. Let's leave those apart. Font of soda? For the S, what are you talking about? Oh, fantasy. Oh my gosh. I still can't get that song out of my head. You guys know which one I'm talking about. And I know you know because you're all about the same age I am. So that's where I'm going to stop talking. So let's cut it. What is that? Well, this is the center point, right? The center point of that line is at about 330 to about 550. Let's do that. Now watch what I'm going to do. So now that I'm in a selection, colors, color to alpha. It's too strong a thing. Hold on, I'm going to get this. In fact, what I'm going to do is I'm going to experiment with the color. Color to alpha. I'm not going to use that color. In fact, think, Aaron, think. Let's use a solid blue and see what that does. That's okay. What if I drop the pink again? Really? You guys don't know the Fanta song? It was like, all these girls, and I can't remember what the whole setup was, but I just distinctly have the song in my head, and it was just, It was like, wanna Fanta? Don't you wanna Fanta? Don't you wanna? And it would just go around and around and around and around and around. And they were like doing stuff, but they were like holding up a Fanta the whole time they were doing it. If you link anything, I won't be able to see it. I'll be able to check on it tomorrow, I guess. I'm gonna widen this selection. I don't want those lines to be so hard. I want them to be small lines. Think. What if I add a color? Literally the solution to every problem in GIMP is adding a layer. Just so you know. Alright, so what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna create another gradient. And it's going to be... I should have... Let me just do regular... foreground to background, but I should be able to do a bilinear. Black and white should be just fine. Not that way. Hold on. In fact, I should be able to do select none here for now. Let's get rid of this other stuff. I've got a layer here, and I've got it. Got a bilinear. Is that going to do what I want it to do? It is. Why is that? It's starting where the center of black is going to be. We're on there. Okay. So then what I want is to make this visible again. Start in the center of this. Go out about that far. Yeah, I'll work with that. Now watch. Colors. And you know what? This might need to be a totally different color from these, like green. Oh, really? I have no idea what that is. Homestuck? What layer am I on? Yeah, I feel like I'm cutting so much stuff out. All I want to do is just cut a little bit. And I should have done this in more stark colors, because then it would be easier to work with. And then I could have added color here. So I may go back and redo this at some point. Let's just bring this down real quick. Do color to alpha on that. So if I do that, I just get a little thin stripe of hex. And now I just need to get a little bit off of there. We need to reverse those. Really? And it's a webcomic, you said? I need that for these to look, come out the way they're supposed to. Now that one actually came out with a little extra tint. Like, it looks great here, and then you add the other one, and then it has too much tint. Huh. There must have been a lot left over from that. It's fine, it's not a huge deal. Yes, it is. Let's put this on top. Yeah, still, how do I get rid of this? Oh, you know what I might be able to do? All right, I got it. I got it. Watch. Watch and learn. Not that one. We use the blue. What's the most even way I can... Alright. We use the blue. We're going to use the opposite of that blue. So, opposite of F9 is going to be... What? A, B, A, B, C, D, E, F. So, 6, 0, 6. Opposite of E0 should be 1F. Maybe it's 1 minus, so that would be 2, 0, and 0, 7. And so, minus 9, what, A, B, C, D, E, F, 1, to be F7, right? We should be on the stark opposite color now of that. Got my bilinear, and I'm going to use that as my thing. Whoa, too much. Whoa, that's lots. Look at all those colors. That's not what I want. Too much. It's a regular bilinear. What do I even have selected? Duh! Oh. No, I just need foreground and background. Just regular foreground and background. Okay, so let's go back to here. And I'm going to make it nice and small. Nice and thin. Right about... Actually, that's not bad. But I'm going to do it right about there. Right? Okay. All right. This is what we're going to do. On this layer, colors, color to alpha. Where are my colors? So if we do that, we should now be looking at that color. Okay, while maintaining the other color. And the reason why this doesn't look transparent now is because I have the same color blue behind it. Okay, so now down here, I can copy this. See, new layers, gradients, alpha channels, does everything. Oh, hey, Jackimus, welcome to chat. Yeah, we're just drawing colors. This definitely isn't part of anything else. All right, so now on this layer, we're going to use color to alpha. Use that color, and that gets my fade back to here. See what we got here? Bam! And what I would like is a floating continent behind there. Like a floating continent, like a solid floating continent right behind the text. But my internet doesn't work, for whatever reason. So that's kind of where we're at. Anyway, I'm gonna get rid of this hacking layer, and I'll make a new one for that. Final Fantasy VI, and I just need a bar. Put you there. All right, so we're looking at the transition from World of Balance to World of Ruin, because that is what we do as hackers. We ruin the game in every which way we can think of with Hex. Final Fantasy VI, hacking. Hacking. I need a good font for hacking. Times New Roman wasn't really that bad. I just don't want it in that color. Thank you very much. All right. Nah. I'm not that good. I'm not that good. I'm just good at working with the little bits of things that I can work with. I think we are enhancing the game. But it's more like the transition, and I'm representing it with an element from the game. So I need something that says hacking, but I don't know what font to do. Alright, what's going on here? Let's do whoop. And we'll make it full size here so I can just justify it instead of having to count pixels. Even though I tend to do that anyway. So you think if I do it that way, it'll look okay? I'm going to make it smaller too. I don't want it to be 110. Not that small though. Let's do... ...82 looks alright. Yes, I know, I gave it a friggin' capital letter. And it's center justified, but I don't think those are quite lined up, so I could be a pixel or two off, so let's fix that. See, I end up doing this crap anyway. Come back over here. It's just a little bit easier to do in this form. And is that spacing good? I can move that stuff later anyway. Alright, so I think I'm done with that. So select by color. Ba-ding! Let's flip and edit stroke selection. Hopefully 2 isn't too much for the word hacking. So now if I go back to this, select none. Now what I'm gonna do. Let's go back up here. I'm going to do stroke selection, except I'm going to do it with one pixel, since everything else is smaller. And that looks really, like, dark or whatever, but I'm going to, or, like, it's faded. And there's a couple of things I can do with this. Either I can just do it again a couple times, and this is probably what I'm going to, the method I'll go about doing it. Okay, so this keeps me from having to add a whole bunch of extra. There we go. That looks good. See? FF6 hacking. But what you can also do, and I found this out when I was working on my splash screen for Children of Vector, was that you can actually select by color, and it grabs like a range around that color. And once you do that, then what you do is you actually can just draw over top of it, and the only thing it'll actually color is what's selected. And so that basically will change it all to a uniform color. But this method works better for our purposes, what we're doing right now. So this is what we're looking at right now. I would love to have a floating continent right here. And I'll probably add an ing. Actually, the ing's from here, so I could add an ing. That's world of balance, so I could put an ing over here. And then, like, one of something else. I don't know, some world of ruin thing. Hey, James, good to see you. Welcome to chat. This is what we've been making today. We started with just a picture of the World of Balance and a picture of the World of Ruin and made this. And what I would like would be a nice big picture of the floating continent right behind the text. But my internet doesn't work, but I can stream. I can stream, but no internet. How weird is that? So that's kind of what's happening. So I'm kind of stuck unless I can get a picture of the World of Ruin, which I can't right now. Yeah, I know, right? Watch. I'll show you. I'll show you. In fact, you know what? Let's use private tab because that uses its own kind of thing. Unless it's been fixed now, which I doubt it has. Like literally, look, it'll just sit here and hang forever. It's like my DNS isn't doing anything. It's like I can be connected, but it's like my DNS went dead. I wonder if I set a specific DNS if it'll work. I don't think so. I don't think so. Oh my goodness. I think my networks are multiplying. And that might be causing some confusion. I might have to like just go in and blow up a bunch of these. Use. That's Google. Hopefully that doesn't blow. It shouldn't blow up anything that's currently connected. If it does, sorry. Yeah, exactly. In case anyone is in need of our services. All right, now they've changed my DNS to Google, which it should have been forwarded to anyway. Continent. Yeah, okay, that's not doing anything. I probably need to restart my computer or stop streaming. I don't know what's up. Does anyone else have any suggestions of things that they think should be on here? Of things that I might actually have available to me? Because currently that is, like, nothing. I have got a bunch of, like, things in here. I do have, like, the monsters from every single game. In fact, we can find the ing, right? H-I... Do-do! That's the ing. Let me save this before we do anything else. Yeah. Yeah. All right. Well, I guess that's then where I'm going to cut it for tonight. Oh, yeah. Was that the one you did for, Yeah, for the 15th man project. I saved that stuff. I also have... That's not it. I have it somewhere, I don't know. The thing Lock Kirby sent me here, look. Woohoo! Hey, guys! That's not it, there we go. Oh, that's just me. Hi. Alright, there we go. You know what? Let's see if Discord works. I'm not hopeful. We're going to see what happens. I generally don't run Discord when I'm streaming because that also chews up some stuff. Do-do-do-do-do. Let's see if it gets there. And for anyone who missed it earlier, these are my layers. The word hacking, the word Final Fantasy, the bar, world of balance, world of ruin, and then multiple transparency layers with gradients to create what I've got left there. Downloading update. Apparently it's doing something. All right, well, I'll let that keep doing its thing. So we can take away the text, we can take away, there, we can take away all this stuff. So originally I just had two pictures of the world, a picture of the world of balance and a picture of the world of ruin. And so I chopped them and I used gradients that I merged onto their layer to fade out parts of it. But what that ended up doing was leaving transparency. And so what I did was I re-added that color back into it, which cleaned up the images. I got a little bit too much on there. Here we go. You told me you expected me to use it on every single stream. And I have not lived up to that quite. But yeah, I save everything. All right. Cool. Someone send me a picture. Oh, wow. You guys were chatting today. All right. Someone send me the a picture of the floating continent. And I'm thinking of the one from Balance and Ruin, the from OC Remix. If there's one that's just a picture of the continent, that would be awesome. Like an artistic kind of one would be ideal. In fact, it would be kind of cool to give it like a gradient and give it a single color, like what would normally be interacting with the word Final Fantasy in any other Final Fantasy banner, like what I did with Children of Vector. But yeah, I don't know. There you go. There you go. Get on that. What you need is a story. All right, somebody either PM me a picture of floating continent or what. Do something, because my browser's just broke. In fact, I bet if I closed my chat window, I'd be able to restart. No, because you know what? I tried Internet Explorer and that didn't work. I'd probably have to restart my computer. No, it's got to be an actual picture. Is it going to do it? Hey, there's a one. Actually, I probably could use that. Copy link, open link. I just want to copy the original. That's not going to do anything for me. Is it? No! No! Aww, that's not going to work. Man, I can't even like save image as. Use a snipping tool. Thing is, it's not, I'm sure it's not correctly sized. I could use my snipping tool to grab a picture of it. Ew, I like that one. Problem is, I can't get, that probably is the actual picture size. All right, come on, snipping tool. Why won't my snipping tool work? There we go. Yep. Haha. Maybe I can use that. I wonder if that'll be recognizable. All right, and I'm gonna take this to see hacking community. All right, got something to work with. Oops, I just closed. Whatever. ~1940 by ~1400. What in the world? Hold on, let me go back to Discord. It should pop right back up. It shouldn't have to go through that whole thing again. Just need to not have that picture open. Balance and Ruin. There it is. Oh, geez, it, like, stopped after, like, a fraction of it. Where's the rest of it? Show it to me! That'd actually be really hard to cut out of there, actually. I'd have to zoom in, and unfortunately, that probably won't work. Too bad. That's a good-looking thing. I'm gonna try this one, though. All right, and so where that's going to go is actually on top of all this stuff. So new layer, floating continent. Yeah, that's right. That's right-ish. All right, so in here, floating continent, edit with GIMP. Yeah, that's what the internet does. All right, so this is what we're going to do. It is currently too small. I'm going to probably double the size of it. But first, I'm going to do a select by color. Oh, and this already added a whole ton of anti-aliasing that didn't previously exist, which is really frustrating. So this probably won't turn out super clean. Let's see if I can grow the selection by one pixel. And then, let's use my dropper, pick up that color. Color to alpha. Oh, whoops, hold on. See, guys, everything's about alpha channels. That's how you make things. That's how I make things. That's the only way I know how to make things. All right, so that should make everything outside of the selection work like that. All right. All right. Select none. Image. Scale image. Let's do 200%. All right. All right, and it looks like there's a little bit of a bar up there from when I grabbed the other thing. So I'm just going to grab about that. I'm just going to grab the amount that I need. Copy this. Hop over here. We're on floating continent. And paste. You know what? That might work. It's anchor layer. I'm going to make that bigger. I'm going to make that bigger. It just kind of disappears back there, and it looks like just kind of like rag or something. So let's get rid of that. And we're going to size you back down. I'd like to do it in all. Scale image. 300%. Okay. Select about that. Copy. And we're over here. Bam! Pull that down just a little. Where do I want that? Where do I want that? Actually, right there is probably right about there. I don't want to take up too much. And maybe it should be in the middle. Because we're already covering up most of the stuff. The point is, hey, it's the map. Hey, it's the map. So yeah, that's not too bad. That's not too bad. And anchor layer. So that's kind of what we're looking at right now. It created a bunch of distortion down here. See? It's a pain in the butt. A pain in my butt. So that kind of bugs me. But otherwise, I kind of like it. And that's what we do. We do hacking. Look at that janky N. Holy cow. All right, so that's what we're going to use. This will be our new banner. I might go back and tweak this and do some other stuff with it at a later time, but this is something that works for now. All right, so last step, we're gonna save, and then we're going to export. Export as FF6 Twitch banner dot ping. And it's made. And I would go set it, like right now. But guess what? I can't do anything on the internet, so we're not going to do that. I know, right? It makes no sense. This used to happen to me for a while, too. But only if I left my computer on and I just closed it when I was leaving work, and then I would get home and I would be switching networks, essentially, for some reason to have a problem, but that didn't happen. I literally turned on my computer, like, 10 minutes before I started streaming. But yeah, so hopefully that all made sense what I was doing. Literally, it just comes down to gradients, you know? Just pictures that you do stuff. So I merged gradients onto those, took them out. So this is a gradient that fixes the color that got lost out of these with a gap in the middle for stuff to come through. Then we have another layer that's tighter that creates kind of the glow that I wanted to have around the hex. Okay. and then text, feathering to create the outline, bar, and our finishing touch, which was the floating continent. So you can take all this like really mundane stuff and actually make something that looks halfway decent. It's all just layers and gradients. And alpha channels. Alright, so that's it for today. Why, thank you. I spent a lot of time trying to figure this stuff out. It helps that I'm ridiculously anal. Which is, like, I literally spent an entire day working this out for my first Children of Vector one. Not GIMP did the wah wah. Waka waka waka. Alright. Thanks. Use more filters. No. Always more filters. There's like never a reason not to use more filters. All right. So that was today. And so next time we'll get back into some Children of Vector, some magic updating. I don't know. I'll work that out when I work it out. But I want to see everyone on the forum because, again, we had another week with basically no activity. And honestly, it's kind of boring me. And so, for my own enjoyment and my own personal entertainment, I need you guys posting more. So, come up with something. Or someone come up with a community game, like a forum game we could do. And put that in the Returner's Hideout. Something that we could do just to get people typing. It doesn't matter what it is. Okay? Alright? Alright. You guys have a good night. Happy hacking. And I will catch you all on the forums and whatnot. So, see you guys then. Bye. Good night.